Hi, it's Mr. Andersen, and this is Thinking in Systems, Level 2. It's on components and interactions. As we define and investigate the system, it'll be represented on that whiteboard, but we should always define what the system is that we're going to study, be it an ecosystem or a chemical system or a physical system. This object will represent the system. Remember, a system is defined by the boundary, but it's also defined by all the parts. Now, as we dig into systems in this video, what we're going to be concerned with is not only the components of the system, but those arrows that are connecting those components in the system, because those are the interactions, and those define the system just as much as the components do. So let me put this over here, and we'll come back to that. After watching this video, you should be able to understand and investigate systems like a marble run, or an ecosystem and a food web. But I'm going to start by showing you my thinking around a simple geared searchlight. So I'll show you this one and then we'll work on a clothespin together. So the first thing you should always do when you're looking at a system is you should define the system. Let me play with it for a second. So there's a light here and I can rotate this. So I can rotate this gray gear and then I can search in different directions. So let me define the system. So I define the system as using a searchlight, and so we're not going to just deal with the searchlight itself, but we're going to deal with my hand, because my hand is going to be using the searchlight. The next thing I should do is I should figure out what are all the components within the system. So I see quite a few components. Let me write all those out. So these are all the components of the system, from the hand, from the gears, to the light, to the board. And so now what I want to do is I want to bring back that whiteboard, and we're going to start analyzing the interactions between the components in the searchlight. And so let me start by working my way across the searchlight. So I'm going to work my way across the searchlight from the right side over to the left side. So the first thing that I would start with is the interaction between my hand and the gray gear. And so my hand moves the gray gear, so I could represent that with an arrow. The next thing that happens is the gray gear is rotating the yellow gear. So as I turn the gray gear, the yellow gear rotates. What I'm noticing is that when I turn the gear in this direction, the yellow gear goes in the opposite direction. So I could say it rotates, and I could also say it rotates it in the opposite direction. I could look at the yellow gear and the orange gear, and we could find that the same thing is going to happen there. So. And now if we look at the light, what is the light doing? Well, as the orange gear moves, then that just moves the light. So I could say the orange gear is going to move the light. Now there's one last piece to the system, and that's going to be the board. That's going to be this board in the back. And if I pull out one of the gears, you can see that there's a hole in it. So the gear is secured into the hole. So this is my thinking around the geared searchlight. And so as I use the searchlight, I move my hand, and you can see that the arrows are moving in the direction almost as if I was reading a sentence. So when I move my hand moves the gray gear, which rotates the yellow gear in the opposite direction, rotates the orange gear in the opposite direction, and then that turns the light. And now you can start playing around with it. So if I remove the yellow gear, what would happen? Well, the gray gear would still be secured, but according to my thinking around systems, if I do that, then the light shouldn't turn, and so I can test that. And so that's a simple way of doing some thinking around the system. Remember, a system is defined by the boundary, the components, but just as important are these interactions between all the components. So now let me get this out of the way, and I'm going to give you one that you can try on your own. Okay, for the second object, we're going to use the using of a clothespin. So if you're not familiar with a clothespin, I squeeze my fingers here, and then I can grab onto something like a piece of paper. So this is the using of the clothespin. So So the system that we're going to investigate is using a clothespin. I've taken the clothespin apart into its parts, which is just these two pieces of wood, and then there's a spring that connects the wood in the middle. So what I'd like you to do is pause the video. I want you to first define all the parts of the system and then use a whiteboard or a piece of paper to show the interactions between the components in the system. Then unpause the video and let's see how our thinking compares. Okay, the first thing I would do is I would define all the parts of the system. Okay, the parts of the system that I defined are my finger, my thumb, two wooden pieces, a spring, and a piece of paper. And so what I'm going to do now is put together the interactions between all the components of the system. Okay, this is my thinking for the system of using a clothespin. My finger and thumb both push on the wooden piece. The wooden piece is held in tension with the spring. So if I take that spring out, there's no tension here. And then the wooden piece is going to push on the piece of paper from either side, and that's how it holds it. So that's components and interactions in a system. What I would encourage you to do now is try one of these other objects. So you could either do the marble run. I've got a Google slide deck below with a video of that. Or you could look at a living system like the food web in an ecosystem. All you do is start by defining what are the important components in the system and then identifying what are all these interactions between the components. That's level 2 on systems, components, interactions, and I hope that was helpful.